talk, talk show. Hello, hello, hello. It's the Chitty Petty Bubble Talk Talk Show.
We will talk about the things that mean so much to you, like going to a restaurant or hanging at the zoo, clothes and sports and funny news, crafts and travel too. Nothing ever scripted, so expect the unexpected.
Hello, hello, hello. It's the Chitty Petty Bubble Talk Talk Show. It's the Chitty Petty Bubble Talk Talk Show.
Hi, welcome to our show. It's Tuesday, November 10th, and Dan the Creature Man is back. Hi, Dan.
Hello, how are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Doing good.
So, how was Halloween? Were you really busy showing creatures to lots of people?
It's not over yet.
Okay.
We've got some creepy things to show you today.
Yeah, what do you have today?
We have a scorpion from Arizona. It's the largest type of scorpion in North America. Not native to Michigan, but Arizona, Texas,
she is big,
California.
I'm going to say she is big.
Okay, so is that an average size for a scorpion in Arizona?
This is the largest type. There are many other types about half the size or smaller. Some are smaller than crickets.
Okay, if we can get a close-up of her right now. She just went back to sleep.
If you...
But he's going to rattle the cage and watch her defense mechanism.
Oh, my God. Is she going to jump?
Intimidating.
No, they're not good jumpers.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, my God. This is so freaky.
Give her a little touch. You'll see the tail go up.
Yes, yes.
Pinchers are ready.
Now she's agitated.
There's the stinger right there.
That's the stinger at the end of the
tail. Does the stinger come out when she stings you? Does it come out like a bee where you go, get the stinger out?
No, and it is ready to sting several more times after the first.
What happens? What should you do when you're bit by a scorpion?
Actually, they sting by the tail, and you'd probably want to get to the hospital just as a precaution. Some are deadly, some are not.
This is as close as I'll ever get to a scorpion.
Okay, and tell us about her. She's pregnant?
I purchased her back in the summer for my creepy crawly Halloween programs I do for the libraries. And in the past few weeks, her belly in the middle has gotten bigger, which tells me she's pregnant.
Did you hook her up with another scorpion?
She must have come pregnant when I got her.
Okay.
Does she want pickles and ice cream?
Ice cream, yeah. Just no.
Really? Ice cream?
No vegetables.
What does a scorpion eat?
Insects, usually.
Other bugs.
Big bugs, yeah.
Oh, boy. She's cute.
When she gives birth, she'll have 10, 12, maybe 14 little babies.
Like praying mantises.
Talk about little bugs. Will she eat them?
No, she'll carry them around on her back until they get too big for that.
Oh, you have to post a picture on Facebook of that.
I sure
really,
will.
Really
they
want to
all
see that.
Live on her?
You know, as creepy as these things are, nobody has a lot of love for scorpions, usually. Scorpions make excellent mothers to their babies. They protect them,
aww,
haul them around. She'll even catch crickets in her pinchers, chop them up, and hand the food to the babies on her back.
Oh, my gosh. Saute them up and put a little salt and pepper.
So the pinchers helps crush, like, shells and stuff?
Yeah, the pinchers defend themselves. I should say they can use the pinchers for defending themselves, catching food, bugs, feeding the babies. Yeah, they're...
Okay, see how she went limp again? She's one tired mama. No, that's fine. I don't want to keep bugging
her.
Yeah,
let's bug something
She's
else.
One tired mama.
How about container number two?
These guys have been hissing. They're really hissed off.
Where are they? Madagascar, they're
yeah,
from.
Hissing cockroaches.
They are going to hiss for us.
Do people eat these cockroaches?
Well, those poor young people put on Fear Factor 10, 15
I've
years
seen
ago.
Them.
Had to deal with these.
But there's no reason to really eat one, right?
They're probably not very good for you.
Yeah. Hey. They're hissing.
Do you hear that?
Yeah, I hear it.
But not only do they hiss, they stand up tall when they hiss.
Yeah, they puff up, try to look big.
Do they bite you?
No.
Okay.
Their legs are picky, so I'll do the holding.
Yeah. Ooh, oh, my gosh.
Let's get a close-up of his legs. Yeah.
Ooh, and it may jump a little, which...
Jumping and hissing. It's not going to jump far, right?
I've seen some a little bigger than this particular guy.
Okay.
Slow down, buddy.
Did you say that we could hold...
Are you going to hold him?
They're very picky legged. Have you ever held a crayfish?
I wouldn't hold that one, Patty.
I'll put my arm out.
It will scratch your arm.
Okay.
How about if you don't?
I don't want to then.
If Dan's saying don't.
What do they eat?
Scraps of food, old
Chitty
bread.
Chitty patties.
They eat anything.
Fruit, veggies, old
you could
bread.
Just let them loosen your garbage and they'd be happy.
Yeah, they're good decomposers, definitely. Look at the
wow.
legs.
So you feed them just anything?
I actually raise them as food items for my big frogs and some of my little alligators.
Oh.
Oh, so they're food themselves.
Is this a boy and a girl?
It is.
So maybe
they seem really happy right now.
Mate.
They're a pretty good couple. They have lots of babies at home resting. And
are they all hissing too? The little babies like hiss quietly?
Real gentle voices.
What kind of parent parenting skills does the hissing cockroach have?
Very basic. Just simple, tough love.
Tough love.
And how many do they have in a litter?
The females lay this egg pod, which has about 30 eggs all clumped together. It's really strange looking. It's yellow. And after she lays this egg pod, the babies all emerge from it in about a week. And they're the size of fruit flies.
So you've witnessed this?
Yeah.
That's cool.
And they walk right away, right?
Yeah, they do.
Scurry or whatever.
They sure do. And they all clump together and stay by the parents. Parents protect them. And the hissing sound is a defense to tell other wild animals that they're...
Gross.
Gross and yucky and need to
they're
be left
gross.
Alone.
Okay, before we move on to the next little creature, I want to ask you about spiders in my own home because they're huge.
Yeah.
And I know they're laying eggs. How can I get rid of them?
There are pesticides you can use. You could always just grab some paper towel and wad it up and grab that whole clump of eggs in the web and throw it in the garbage in the garage.
Okay, I don't want to use pesticides because that's poison and I
Definitely.
Don't want that in my home. But what about just vacuuming them up, isn't that?
They may survive in the vacuum bag if you leave it unattended.
Oh, Pledge. What if you put Pledge or Fantastic on them? I've done that,
Vinegar, rubbing alcohol.
It tortures them, though.
I know. And I don't like to even torture them.
I know. I don't want to, but they're big and scary, and I don't want them having 300 little spiders in my living room.
And if you leave them be, they'll probably have more babies quickly.
Oh,
okay. Yeah, because sometimes I feel bad and go, I'll let you live, and it's like, no.
Sure.
Well, I try to catch spiders and let them outside, but there comes a point where you just got to...
Yeah, twice this week.
Do you want me to capture them and you can feed them to...
If they're big, I can use them, sure. Oh, man.
Oh, my gosh.
I'll start my own little creature
business. Pledge-covered spiders.
Okay, so tell us about this pretty little frog. What is he?
This is a female red-eye tree frog.
She is gorgeous.
And these you find all over.
I want to touch her, can I?
She's really slimy.
Well,
I have paper towel. And she may jump.
Okay, then forget it. Oh, my God.
Right at you.
Oh, my God.
She's telepathic.
She wants me to touch
her. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Oh, I'm freaking out. No, she's going to jump at me.
It's called a red-eye tree frog, and they... live in Central America.
She's secreting her own oil on your finger.
Yeah, did you see that?
Does it? Why? That's more comfortable for her?
She's scaring me.
She can hold on to you better.
Yeah. I've got her good.
My heart rate just went up. You know why? I'm afraid if she goes and I'm going to go like that, I'm going to kill her
accidentally.
She's
so pretty.
She's
gorgeous. She always upright.
You know, when I purchased her, she was a little baby the size of a green pea. And she was just all green.
And do you have to let her out for exercise? Because clearly she needs to stretch.
She has a big cage. Oh, yeah. She's got a nice big cage with live plants and sticks and branches in
it. And she jumps in there and plays?
Yeah, at night with her boyfriend.
She has a boyfriend?
Yeah. He's a little bit smaller.
Oh, please. Oh, my God. Oh, I don't want to hurt her. I'm so scared. I'm going to.
She's ready to do it again. You ready?
Wait, let's go to the wide shots.
Please face her that way.
I want everybody to see her jump. What? She's getting
no, not towards me. Not towards me.
Go see Patty.
My God. She just jumped right into her little dish.
Oh. No, I'm afraid I'm going to go like that and kill her.
Sure, they are delicate.
She's very fragile.
She keeps looking at me, I swear. Look at...
Oh. You know what it feels like?
I want to touch
Jello. Cool, sticky.
Oh, yeah, see, she...
Here she comes again. I'm just
going
to watch
them.
Her
she's
legs
not going to jump
are
right
so
now,
long. Okay. Yeah, look at she's climbing.
Oh,
her
she's
legs are so long.
Yeah, look at.
I just don't want to hurt her. She's very cool, though.
What do you feed her?
Small crickets, normally. Little worms, too.
Do you think she could take on that screeching cricket?
The roach?
Yeah.
Too big.
Oh, yeah, okay.
It needs to be something just the size of a fly or a smaller cricket.
Clearly, she would not make a good frog leg dinner.
No.
Unless
you're on a diet.
Skinny little legs.
Yeah, look at
wow,
them.
She is cool, though.
They are tree dwellers. Nocturnal.
Really
they come out
cool.
at night.
Aww. Well, so what about her vision? Why are her eyes... Oh, she totally wanted to land there. That was perfect. Tell me about her eyes and her vision.
They see real good at night when everything's dark or dim under moonlight. They don't like bright lights.
This is probably not good for her.
Even outside in the daylight is hard on them long term. Their eyes just aren't made to look... into it.
Oh my gosh, Patty.
Come to Daddy. She may jump back at me. But the colors, this is not a poisonous frog. Many of them are. She wants to look poisonous. So the birds and the snakes, where they live in Central America, won't try to eat them. Come on back one more time. Go.
You can do it.
Oh my gosh.
Come on.
Go on. Just, okay. I feel safer with her in there. This is a giant killer frog, but...
So what is her prey? What does she have to watch out for in the wild?
Some of the snakes that live in trees, birds, bats.
Bats.
And a lot of frogs are cannibals, so if a big frog of this type sees a little baby, and it's not quick enough, that little baby will get eaten.
Well, you got to survive.
Survival of the fittest.
Oh, Scorpio's adorable. Getting angry over here.
Oh, scorpion. Wow, on her own.
This thing, okay.
I think she's having contractions.
This thing looks fake.
Okay, yeah, what is this?
This is a giant African millipede, which is still young and growing. She may get about twice the size.
Oh, boy.
They can reach 13 to 14 inches. Think of a foot-long hot dog.
Could you
next
put her in a bun?
Next time you go to the Coney.
Okay, did she move really slow, right?
Yes, very slow. They don't run. This is the head end. The tail over here.
Does it curl up?
Sometimes they do. If they're being pestered by a predator, they will curl up and then squirt poison out of all these little grooves in the skin.
How poisonous is it?
To humans, it's like glue. It smells bad. It's not coming out right now.
It just makes you want to wash your hands.
I mean, would it squirt and hit us?
No, it just gets moist. Little droplets on the skin.
Now, what is his vision? Because he has those big antennae in the front. Looks like he's feeling around with that.
Yeah, those antennas just are for feeling and picking up smells in front of them.
There's no smell or anything in that dish. Is it a little disappointed?
Yeah.
Is it bored?
It's a girl. She'd love to be munching on a piece of apple or some squash, some greens.
She's a vegetarian.
She likes protein, too, though. She eats chicken and cat food.
Chicken?
No dog food.
She'd probably like some tofu. If it was flavored.
You have all these creatures that eat chicken. You should raise some chickens.
Kroger's doing pretty good right now, but if I have leftovers at home.
Okay, so what is what else can you tell us about this one?
They come from Africa. They're ground dwellers, real slow, but related to centipedes, which are quick and very pinchy.
Oh, they dig into the ground? They live underground?
You know, if they were crawling around, if they saw like a log on the ground with space under, they'd hide under there. Or leaf litter, they call it, you know, just soft soil that's got sticks and leaves dried up, mixed together. Soft soil they'll burrow into.
So people in Africa, like, get these in their house like we get spiders and go, oh, get a tissue.
Yeah, do people eat them?
I don't think so.
Is there any
really
meat?
Doubt it.
No?
You know,
just
I've seen documentaries on TV showing, like, a meerkat.
Can I touch it?
Yeah, or a mongoose. They'll actually eat these animals. Big lizards, hawks. It kind of feels like a snail shell.
Hello.
Smooth, crunchy. But 200 legs on the bottom side.
200? See, I always thought there was 100.
I thought there was a million.
Two rows, though. There's 100 on each side.
Oh.
It, like, folds in half.
So somebody's counted those.
Yeah.
Does it tickle?
Oh, you could make it like
Halloween.
A mustache.
A little mustache.
Nowadays.
You're pretty intimate with your... creatures. Look at, it's funny how it can roll itself over.
That
strange
is
animals.
A really cool animal. So is that considered an insect?
I wanted to touch my...
It's in a weird family of animals called myriapods.
I don't know, I can't do that.
Hey, let me just show you one more odd thing and
a
then
trick?
We'll move on to spider. Just how they walk.
That is just incredible.
Very mechanical.
Oh, like sections stay together.
Yeah, the legs ripple in a pattern.
Oh my gosh, it's a wave, right.
Isn't that cool?
That is so cool.
Come on back where you can be seen on camera, girl. She's not used to TV sets too much yet.
She is very cool. She could, like, clean your floor. It's like a little broom.
If you have me back in a year or two, she could be a foot long.
And how long will she live?
They can live for about 15 to 20 years. Bizarre animals.
Really bizarre.
It's taken a long time to get used to handling some of these things.
So do you have to have a schedule? Like, I'm sure you have to give them all some type of physical activity and let them out. How do you keep that organized?
These things don't need a lot of exercise. The frog...
He does.
Yeah.
Yeah, they like to jump and climb. Most of these are pretty solitary. In the wild, they mostly come out to look for food or water.
And you take care of that, so they're...
Yeah, I do provide them with all they need. This one.
Okay, Mr.
Oh, my gosh. Is this going to jump?
No, not
God.
A jumping tarantula. This is the kind you'd find down in Argentina.
And what's his personality
I have goosebumps.
Like?
It's a female.
She's
actually very docile, tame.
Yeah.
Look at this.
Oh, my God.
She's not surprised by me touching her.
So is she poisonous right now?
Yes, but nothing deadly to humans. It would be like
she
a bad
beautiful.
Beast thing.
I mean,
yeah, the coloring's really nice.
Very, very
If you'd
beautiful.
Like to feel, it feels like a pipe cleaner. soft and fuzzy.
You are so brave, Patty.
And I've got the head pointed away from you. The head's over here.
Why is she losing hair on the back of her body?
Sometimes when they're agitated, they will rub their back legs.
Oh, she's upset.
To flick the fur off of their abdomen, it's called, as a defense. So she will brush the fur off of her back, and it's picky, and that would be into the face of some predator that's chasing her.
She is really big.
And how fast can she move?
About like a chipmunk or a mouse.
Wow, that's really pretty fast.
They can zip around very quickly, and they can climb smooth surfaces like plastic, glass.
Do they have, she have these little curtains. Claws that she can...
They have these little hooks on their toes.
This guy wants big.
I always hear little kids at school say, yeah, they got suction cups on their toes. No, they don't. They've got these tiny little hooks, little spurs. They're microscopic. They can cling to any surface. Well, not any, but... Yeah, as she's sliding
what
down.
What does she eat?
Usually big bugs like the roaches, bigger crickets.
Do you think she's getting hungry looking at these guys? Like, can she see them and go, oh.
Probably not. Not right now. She's distracted with all the lights and me handling her. But she will grow about an inch or two larger.
Oh, my gosh.
She'll get to be about the size of my hand. It's called a Chaco golden knee tarantula. Chaco is the region from Argentina they live,
so
the province.
Do these show up in people's houses and say... Get me a tissue.
They probably do. If you live out in the countryside, you might see these, just like people in Arizona or Texas. You know, in your shed or by the wood pile. If you're farmers, they see these outside a lot.
What would you do if you were living out there and had found one in your home?
Me personally?
Yeah.
I'd love it. No. I'd probably just make sure it didn't come into my home.
Chew it out of the house.
Family. Yeah,
sweep
it
out. You just sweep it out.
I'd probably just pick it up and put it out.
Yeah.
Take some pictures of it.
I'd probably spray pledge on it.
Yeah.
And how do you know, is there a warning when it wants to bite you?
You know, most of the time, when they see something as big as a human, they take off and go the other way.
Yeah.
Or they don't even let you get close to them in the first place.
We have to remember that we are a lot bigger than all of these beautiful creatures.
You could just stomp on them.
You know, I have a good friend.
I mean, I don't want to, but I would. I
have a good
to.
Friend lives in Arizona, and he sees all these creepy, crawly things around his home in the desert, probably on a daily basis.
You would love that.
Whenever I visit him, it's a blast.
Well, I vacationed in Phoenix, and I don't think I saw any.
You'd be like,
do you think they saw me?
You'd have to kind of go look for them a little bit. But like in driveways or, you know, like behind a dumpster, you could find a scorpion living where bugs are.
Right.
They always follow insects.
Okay. All right. Well, we have some other special guests.
How about
not on the table.
This guy.
A cute little baby alligator.
Active. He almost escaped in the studio.
Little pole boy sandwich.
Little po' boy Sammy.
Well, he looks agitated.
He won't eat the bread, but he would eat part of the meat from a sandwich, especially a po' boy.
Look at his tongue.
This is Albert.
So pink.
Albert.
Back in the summer, a friend of mine who works at a local pet shop called and said, Dan, there are these people in Birmingham. They bought a little alligator for their son. He's afraid it's going to bite him, and they don't want it. So it's free, but you have to go pick it up today or tomorrow. So I picked it up right away, and
now,
it came to me.
Teeth are small, but they look sharp.
This is an American alligator. When they're little, they have 60 little sharp teeth, just like a kitten. You ever been playing with a little kitten or a puppy and those little teeth?
Yes.
And those little animals don't mean to hurt you, but these teeth, just like those, are so sharp.
They look sharp.
Yeah.
They look very sharp.
Do they lose their teeth?
They can and regrow them quickly throughout their whole lives. Yeah.
Or do those teeth grow bigger? Because dogs lose theirs and get new ones.
They will too, quite regularly. And when they're full size, they can have up to 80 teeth instead of 60 when they're little.
He is really cute.
What's the status of alligators in the U.S.? You know, are they healthy? Are they dying off? They seem to be stronger than ever.
Yeah, they are.
Well, you saw a 300-pound one in the mall that was on the online.
It happens all the time where people, like in Florida, there's encounters with these animals at pools, beaches.
Golf courses. They eat little dogs and stuff.
But they seem to survive the pollution pretty well.
They do.
Right?
And, you know, us humans are very good at taking over a whole area and not leaving much space for animals. And it doesn't seem to bother them too much.
Can I touch him?
Sure thing. Let me just turn the head away.
Turn him towards me.
I'm not afraid
of... Don't touch the diaper, Paula.
It's okay.
Oh, he's very... Oh, he's
Albert.
Really nice.
Does he like to be touched?
Not really.
Oh, sorry.
It's okay.
I'm like
You're
getting into it here.
It's all right. You know, he won't be able to go back to be a wild creature.
His belly is really soft.
I like it.
They're farm raised, sadly. for the skin industry,
oh,
the restaurant industry, and the pet industry, which I used to be a part of.
So that must be an unfriendly environment, right? The way people are raising them for food?
I've never seen the conditions of that type of thing. And I tried alligator meat at a restaurant in Florida once.
It's tough.
I'll go back to chicken anytime.
Is it like chicken? Oh, I was going to say.
It's tougher.
It's tougher, yeah. It's kind of like deep fried bacon texture. Pork rinds. It's yucky.
He looks perfect. He looks like a chewy toy.
Very healthy little guy.
He really does look healthy.
He was skinny when I got him a few months ago.
How sharp are the claws?
I'd say similar to like a small cat or a lizard. You can feel the foot if you'd like. They are webbed on the back.
Oh, yeah, that's very soft.
But he doesn't, does he ever hit you? I mean, can he hurt you with, grab the, you?
Yeah, if he bit me, I would need to wear a Band-Aid for a couple of days. It would be a bad little bite.
What is his
the claws?
Claws.
Not too bad, no.
What does his house look like? Where does
he live? He lives in a 60-gallon aquarium right now. It's 4 feet long and real deep.
And they grow so fast. How do you keep up with the...
I have one that's going to be going to a zoo by Frankenmuth very shortly. It's just over 4 feet long and hard for me to handle.
Where is the zoo by Frankenmuth? Yeah. I want to visit.
It's called Wilderness Trails Zoo. It's just about 2 miles south of the Frankenmuth area.
He's hissing.
Is that him? Ooh.
Hear that?
Yeah.
When they're young like this, they make that sound to call their big mother to swim over and chase predators away.
I've heard that noise before.
It's saying, Mom, Mom, chase these people in this TV set out of here.
Where's his mom, I wonder?
At some alligator breeding farm.
Well, let's let him get back to resting,
because
we have another special little guest
who has been
making a lot of noise back here.
Going to join the Chatty Patty show, because...
He knows he's up. She knows he's up next.
She talks a lot.
This is a 30-year-old. Up. She's got stage fright. Come on, over here. Up. Come on. There we go.
It's finally your turn. What's her name again?
Jamila.
Hello.
Jamila is very cute.
African gray parrot. Hey, are you happy today?
Very sweet.
Oh, she's beautiful. And yeah.
She is an animal that needs a lot of attention and some freedom, you know, a change of pace.
Well, birds live a long time, and they're quite loyal to you if they like you, right? We've all seen Polly, the movie, right?
Yeah.
How many times have you seen Polly?
I haven't seen it once. No.
Polly?
You got to see the movie Polly. It's about a parrot. And it's sad, but then happy.
Oh, as long as it ends happy.
But it's about the bird's relationships with all its owners. Because it's different, right? How do they treat humans?
You know, kind of how you treat them, like dogs and cats. If you're usually very kind to them, usually they're very relaxed and mellow. Birds are a lot the same way. Can I have a kiss?
Oh.
She'll let me hug her a little bit.
I thought you were talking to me.
Ooh. Was that her fart noise?
Yeah. Oh. Say, excuse me, please.
Hello.
Hello.
She makes
hello.
A wide variety of sounds.
Does clicks. Does she hello. Quiet down at night? Like, or is she keeping you up at night? So she sleeps and it's like, okay.
I turn the lights off to all my animals at about 10 o'clock every night, and she gets quiet.
Now in the morning, is she like, hey, hello, hello, come
on. Yeah, around 8 o'clock, the lights all go back on, and she's wide awake and ready to have breakfast.
And what's her breakfast?
The leftovers from the night's dinner the day before.
Oh.
Last night it was some chunks of leftover pumpkin from Halloween.
Mm.
I chop it up, sliced up carrots, bananas, some Cheerios.
Does she eat eggs? Or that be
green
like
beans uncooked. Love scrambled eggs.
Oh.
Pasta, noodles.
So is there someone in your house that she doesn't take to?
My wife and my son.
And how does she treat them badly?
If they try, like they have, to pick her up like I do, they will get bitten if she doesn't like them too much.
And it hurts. Will they bleed?
She would give them a very painful bite. It's happened. My wife has kind of given up on trying to handle the birds.
Yeah.
Which,
because all the birds prefer, the magic of TV.
You knew that was coming.
Yeah. Feel better now? We go up?
He said she squats.
Oh. She is releasing feathers.
Yeah, you see the feathers? Up, one more. Come on.
Say hello.
She's a good little bird, though.
Now, how long have you had her?
Since 1999. So I guess almost 17 years.
Has she grown? Was she, like, smaller when you got her?
No, I'm her second owner. She was about 12 or 13 when I got her. And the lady that had her before me just was never married or did not have kids and wanted to travel. She was retiring and wanted to not have to stay home for
a bird.
Did
they have a good relationship, her and
the
bird?
Best friends.
Aww.
And the lady was real sad.
And was the bird sad?
You know, she didn't like me. I was a single guy and usually up late quite a bit in my single days, and I was nothing like a middle-aged lady back then, so
But you are now.
Yeah, so quite a bit.
You were probably coming home late from going out, and she was like, hey, keep it down.
Yeah. It took her about a year to warm up to me and trust me.
So when she looks at you, I notice she puts the eye up. Is that the eye that's looking at you?
Yes. Like if you moved around or lifted your arm, she'd look at you, and then if you did the same, they can kind of follow.
So I'm testing her vision. Well, how many fingers am I holding up?
I can tell she really likes you because she likes attention because once we picked her up, she quit talking.
Yes.
Can you make her talk?
I have not figured out a way to trigger her to talk. Not yet.
She was just talking away the whole time we were looking at all these guys.
Hello.
Yeah, she says about six or eight phrases regularly. She imitates all the sounds you hear in a home, electronics like your microwave.
Does she pick up new stuff if someone new comes into the house? How quickly?
It can take several months for her to pick up words or phrases.
Mm-hmm. Does she swear?
Not anymore.
Well, that means they don't swear in their
home.
I'm
a dad now, so I've kind of
when he was single.
I've heard stories about swearing birds. They can't get them to stop.
I purchased a bird just like her, a male, very cheaply from a chiropractor. And after about 3 days, this bird got more comfortable with me and started only saying really bad words.
Oh, my gosh.
And I had to pass it on to somebody else because I had a son that was 2 years old back then.
Yeah.
Well, what advice can you give people at home, you know, if they have or want some kind of crazy pet like you have?
Find out as much as you can before you purchase the pet. You know, get a book. Talk to other people that have them. Ask questions. Don't rush into buying any pets. Even a dog. You know,
I know.
They're constant care.
It
any
is
of these
true.
Exotic pets too, even especially these things. Not that a lot of people want to have these, but no matter what it is, you should provide for it if you take it into your home and
Which is your most fulfilling pet? Like, what brings you the most pleasure?
I have that parrot and another one. I'd say they're my little buddies. These creepy things I use for my school programs. They don't really do a whole lot for me. I think they're interesting, but there's nothing personal there. Just science.
Well, I think it's interesting that kids get a chance to see this stuff up close and not just on TV or in a photo.
Definitely. Like, and things you might encounter on vacation somewhere. People like to travel, and especially young people, they'll see these things if they're playing on the beach or at the hotel in
Costa Rica or something. Lizards in Mexico, like all over, big ones.
Did you pick them up?
No.
Oh, big ones.
Like
iguanas.
Iguanas, yes.
Yeah. One more before we go?
Oh, yes, sure.
What's in here?
Probably one of my favorite little reptiles.
Oh, yeah, right.
A panther chameleon.
The panther
adorable.
Chameleon.
I forgot.
This little guy is just about a year old, he will grow larger.
Gosh. We need a close-up.
We call him Rainbow.
Oh, he's beautiful.
He is so cute.
You said that's his tongue under there? He's got a pretty long tongue?
Tongue here
is
jammed into his throat now. If he wanted to catch an insect, he could stretch it about a foot from his head.
Wow.
To catch the bug. Right now he's agitated. He doesn't like the bright lights.
Oh, his eyes are closed,
tense.
Right?
It's okay.
Yeah, he's holding on tight. Oh, he's got his hand up.
He's got like two, like a claw like this.
Let me see if he will let me show you that. Look at his little feet.
Look at how
he's
cute.
Precious.
They're
we
tree
get a
dwellers.
Close up of him?
So they,
yeah, they did.
Are designed for living on branches, sticks, vines.
Oh, right. He's got the...
His little hands are adorable. They're just adorable.
And a tail called a prehensile tail for climbing.
Oh.
Isn't that cool?
Oh, my gosh.
Look
at his back legs.
His back legs are so cute.
And he'll get about twice the size to be about as big as a banana. He will get more colorful, too.
He is beautiful.
He's the size of a banana.
And where's he from?
Madagascar.
Madagascar.
Are his eyes closed? Because they look
closed.
No,
they are open. They're just very tiny.
Oh, they are tiny.
See that?
It's like a little hole.
Yeah. He was born in Wisconsin.
Oh.
By a breeder who produces them and sells them.
So he likes cheese, huh?
Yeah, he does. Mars Cheese Castle on the way to Chicago.
He is absolutely beautiful.
All right, well, thanks a lot, Dan, but we got to go.
Thanks for having us back.
Thank you for watching the Chatty Patty.
Paula Walla.
Talk Show.
Hello, hello, hello. It's the Chatty Patty Paula Walla Talk Show. Hello, hello, hello. Hello. It's the Chatty Patty Paula Walla Talk Show.
We will talk about the things that mean so much to you, like going to a restaurant or hanging at the zoo. And funny news, crafts and travel too. Nothing ever scripted, so expect the unexpected.
Hello, hello, hello. It's the Chatty Patty Paula Walla Talk Talk Show. It's the Chatty Patty Paula Walla Talk Talk Show. It's the Chatty Patty Paula Walla Talk Talk Show.